Welcome back to the next segment, this week on response and adaptation to disability. Most of this segment and the rest of today's lesson will be led by Dr. Deborah Gough, who's a professor at Northern Illinois University. I'll turn it over to Dr. Gough, who will tell you a little bit more about different ways in which people go through grief and loss and adaptation to disability.
I'm Deb Gough, and I am a professor in the School of Allied Health and Communicative Disorders. My area is in rehabilitation counseling, and my area of expertise within that is around disability as an issue of loss, how one adapts to that particular loss, what that process is like. So that's what I'd like to talk with you about today. How does adaptation work, and how does that look, and what does that feel like for people who are involved? I'm going to start out by talking to you about a concept called attachment dreams. When we think about attachment dreams, really what I'm talking about are those kinds of hopes and expectations and wishes that we all have for how our life is going to be, who we are going to be in our life, what makes us valuable and strong and important. Sometimes when we have dreams like that, things go wrong. And this is especially difficult when they're the really important things in our lives that go wrong. Things like disability. Disability for ourselves, for our children, for a family member. So when we think about disability, what happens to those dreams that we have? Particularly, let's talk about the dreams that parents have about their children. Everybody has attachment dreams about who their child's going to be, what they're going to be like. We all have dreams that our children will be normal and healthy and grow up happy and have friends and be successful. Those are typical dreams. But each person who is a parent usually has even more specific dreams about who their child is going to be for me, for the parent. When disability occurs in childhood, the disability experience shatters the dreams that the parents have. That kind of shattering of dreams is what starts the process rolling around adaptation, as we've been talking about it in these clips. When we think about situations where something has occurred that is a loss to us, some way in which our life has been significantly changed in ways we did not wish for or plan, it can create what's called the family pressure cooker. In this case, we look to our family and our close friends to be our supports. But sometimes, in times of stress and need, those who typically give us the most support are experiencing their own stress, their own pressure, because they have lost something too. They are also unable sometimes to make us feel better, because at this point in time, this is just how we need to feel. We need to go through and struggle with what has happened with the loss around disability. There's a common belief that there are steps and stages around loss and adjustment to loss, but what I want to share with you is what happens when a dream is shattered. The first most important thing for people to recognize is that the person who has lost a dream around disability, for example, first needs to come to a recognition of what was lost. Many people try to be brave and strong and say, it doesn't matter, life's going to be just the same as it always was, we'll be fine. And while that looks brave and strong, it really isn't helpful to the individual because they're not able to recognize what has changed. We need to recognize what has been lost, what is different, so that we can create some new attachment dreams, so that we can figure out who our child is now, who we are now as parents, or if it's your spouse who has the disability, who are you now as a spouse? Who is your spouse going to be now and in the future? It's a lot to figure out. So people experience this loss, dreams get shattered. It tends to be a period of denial wherein we have a hard time recognizing what was lost. Following that, there are a lot of really difficult feelings around adjustment and adaptation to loss, around disability or any other loss. But these painful feelings are really important. They are part of a normal, necessary, healthy process that helps us let go of dreams that can no longer be and create new, healthy, positive, hopeful dreams for the future as we are now changed and as we can look to the future. The whole process of adaptation starts around the loss, around the ability to recognize what was lost. We have also talked about the fact that the people we typically count on to be our supports may not be able to do that in quite the same way. We may find other people in our lives who now have a new role with us. Could be your neighbor, could be a minister, could be a nurse, could be a therapist. So we need, in adaptation, we need to be open to adapting. And part of that openness is finding those new supports, allowing yourself to talk with people about your feelings, those really difficult feelings around loss, things like anger and fear and grief and the terrible sadness that we feel, which are all part of a normal process. So, in summary, hopefully you'll see that adaptation is an allowance for ourselves to change, an allowance for us to recognize that life is not the way we dreamed it initially, but that we have different ways now to look at ourselves, our children, our spouses, our families, into the future, and how to create a dream that provides positive direction for us to follow. That's the essence of adaptation. And when we come back from the break, we're going to take a look at different strategies and ways that we can be helpful to individuals who are in this process of adaptation. How can we be helpful? How can we be comfortable in those situations?